Now we have with us our esteemed speaker, Professor Indira Parikh, who is the former president of FLAME, Foundation of Liberal and Management Education Institute. Previously, she was the Dean of IIM Ahmedabad from 2002 to 2005. She was a faculty member at IIM Ahmedabad for over 30 years. She has also taught at INSEAD, Fontainebleau and Texas and A&M University. She has specialized in organization development and design and institution building. Ma'am, we are honored to have you here.
I would like to first thank the organizers for inviting me and second for presenting such a nice event. I have always had the privilege of either being the first batsman in the opening or the first batsman after lunch. By lunch, they have provided you such a sumptuous lunch, so the drowsiness must just be setting in. But it is the best time to tell stories of making statements, because that stage there is going to be dark when you are half asleep. I am going to talk about share four things with you: the purpose of education, the context of education, creating a learning environment, and the students. When I was starting to think about what I need to present, I kind of reflected of how long I have been doing this. I have been teaching since I was 8 years old. I come from a family of 40 plus people, family members, and my father had a small textile unit. He had a lot of workers and the workers lived around the factory. So there were lots of children and I was good at studies. I'm told that at the age of 2.5, I was reading a newspaper and my grandfather came and said, "Where is his newspaper?" So I told my grandfather, "Pitaji, but I have to also see," at 2.5 I was saying, "what is happening in the world?" So it was said that I'm good at studies, so my father started the school, and when I was 8 I would come back from school, and at that time we had holidays on Thursdays and Sundays. So Thursdays and Sundays from 9 to 12 I had a group of 40 young children, young and old, beginning with 3 to 14, and I was 8 years old. I was teaching them what I was learning the previous week in the school. That was reading, writing, arithmetic, and something about the world, whatever little information I had. And then I have been a student all my life, because I got married at a very early age, and I studied 8 years after my marriage. I got my BA, another 1 year I got my master's, and another 8 years I got my PhD. So I have either been a student or I have been a teacher. And being a teacher, I thought, was the best thing to happen, because as I said, coming from a very large family, my uncle was a terror in the family. But my eldest aunt, that is my father's sister, was a school principal and she had done PhD in Sanskrit. Whenever she would come, the terror uncle would get up and become like a mouse. He would call her elder sister, he would call her. So I used to look at it and I said, good to be a teacher. Nobody would be, everybody would be frightened of me, so nobody would fight with me. So being a teacher has been a very important aspect. And when I think of the purpose of education, when I was asked to start playing, I was thinking, what is it that I want to do? What is it that I would like to bring to the young people? And I said, what is basically the purpose of education? And actually, we have lost the purpose of education in the history, because we only believe that the education is when the colonizers came. And we carry that map, and we have 500 years of amnesia. The whole culture, the whole country, that we don't believe that we had something called shiksha before the colonizers came. And colonizers have done a very fine job of eroding all that was available in the country to say only they have started it. And I think that creates a context in the education system which somehow does not make sense at the soul level to the child. And unless we touch the soul of the children or the young generation, we really cannot make an impact of transformation. So it's very important to understand what was our context. Now, there is a role of a teacher in the ancient times, which was that of a guru. We have become teachers for preparing young generation for occupation. But the teachers have lost the concept or the value of what it means to be a guru. As far as education is concerned, or learning is concerned, unless teachers accept their gurudom, and gurudom is not necessarily preaching and teaching, but bringing lot about life and lot about the wisdom that the students will get interested. Now, when I talk about context, the purpose of education. The purpose of education is to create an environment where the young people experience freedom, freedom to think, freedom to feel, freedom to have a spirit of inquiry, and freedom to make choices. And most important, to differentiate between what is right and what is wrong. If they can do that, then they are set for life. Now, we prepare children for getting a career. We don't prepare them for life. And it's very important that life has to be, and life has the wisdom of centuries. And this wisdom has been with us for a long time. And I think we need to really accept and ground ourselves. Unless we have a ground, we cannot put down roots. And unless we don't have roots, we cannot really flower and blossom. So it's very important to have our roots very sorted out. Who we are, what is our belonging system, and where do we wish to go. And this needs a lot of self-reflection. Self-reflection today is very frightening to the young people. To even ask them to be alone and have no contact and no stimulation frightens the hell out of young people. I teach a course called Explorations in Roles and Identity. And I have one exercise of 45 minutes where this young person has to just sit and just let the thoughts come and let him wander into the wherever his mind wants to wander. They cannot sit for more than 15 minutes without looking around or talking to somebody. And no matter how many times we tell them, do not talk, they will talk. They cannot just be silent and they cannot be self-reflective. We have stopped helping young people to be silent, to have solitude, to be self-reflective. It's very important to create that kind of a context. Learning environment, see, we are either student-centric or we are teacher-centric. For a long time, we have been teacher-centric. Teacher will teach and the students will learn. After some time, with all kind of research coming in, it became student-centric. So students can do what they like, what they want. You just cannot stop them, you cannot interrupt them. And therefore, they became entitled to everything they want. There is a whole culture of appeasement of the students, and the students feel entitlement. And this really takes away the whole learning environment. Learning environment has to be where students feel happy in learning, where students want to come to school, where students want to be happy at school. And learning environment means discovery. So that discovery needs spirit of inquiry. Why, what, why not, why not? And that would only create an environment of learning. And teachers have stopped learning. And nobody has pushed them, so they've learned to get up again by themselves and walk the path again. And they have also come across huge spaces of land with beautiful flowers, mountain springs, and they've come to discover the infiniteness of the possibilities of their potentials. So my statement is that every child today, every individual, our country, our families are both at a crossroad and a threshold. Crossroad because they have to make really choices, out of multiple choices, and they have to cross the threshold to this, enter into a new space which did not exist before because of the technology. Unless we provide the young people with a sound set of values and a commitment to themselves, the people around, the country around, it will be very difficult for them to grow up. They will learn a lot of things, but they will not become wise. Because if we don't own up our wisdom of our centuries, we really cannot grow up and feel proud and be rooted to really possible. Thank you very much.